cardiac disease progression is a significant global concern and is really the leading cause of death worldwide. Really, there's a need to develop better in vitro models to study disease progression using engineered heart muscle tissues.
So our laboratory has really been working for a long time on engineering and building human heart muscle tissue so that we can understand both how disease manifests, but also we can ultimately create therapeutic tissues so that someone who's had a heart attack or other kinds of heart disease, we could actually repair or replace that one day. So, you know, one of the challenges in building heart muscle tissue is that we have to build these little tiny pieces in a dish, and people have been doing that for many years. But what we realize is that these little, what we call in vitro systems or in the petri dish, don't really accurately recreate the loading we see in the real heart, specifically what we call both the afterload, which is when the heart muscle contracts, but also when it relaxes and those ventricle chambers fill with blood, that's called the preload. And we weren't really ever able to model that before.
We sought to better understand this by incorporating a system that can apply loads to an engineered heart muscle tissue, or an EHT. To do this, we incorporated a polydimethyl siloxane strip, which is used to mimic the physiologic loads on engineered heart muscle tissues.
And what that means is that we can actually build a better heart muscle, but also recreate situations that better understand the manifestation of different kinds of heart disease.
We were able to show that dynamic loading with this Dyne EHT system, we were able to create more functional engineered heart muscle tissues, which we hope will be better able to repair the adult heart when it becomes damaged.
So one of the exciting parts about this work is it's a collaborative effort between my lab here at Carnegie Mellon and then also my collaborator in the Netherlands, Peter Vandermeer, who's a cardiologist.
This is important for being able to ensure reproducibility in research, but also in being able to compare findings across the world.